anything of your experience from your real high school? Are you?
No.
This is not at
again.
All?
I didn't play football, or I wasn't a jock in high school by any means.
Okay.
I mean, of course, there's like the cliques and there's like the popular kids and these different archetypal characters that we see. But no, I mean, this is. But I feel like high school is so different because I'm 29.
Yes.
And I haven't been in high school for over a decade, so I can see how things have changed with social media and. Kids are just, they're going through a whole new world now.
I know. I've got three kids who are going to soon, you know, at least my oldest one is going to enter that. And I am quite honestly not looking very much forward to it.
I don't blame you, but you know, it's tough. I think they're growing up a lot faster now than maybe when I was in high school.
So if you went back to your, what's your high school that you went to?
Langley High School.
Langley High School.
Yeah, right by the CIA.
So would that be, wow, is that right?
The backyard of the CIA. Yeah, like if you were driving towards my high school, there's like a driveway that drives into the CIA that a lot of people accidentally drive into. And every single time you go down there, it's like an hour process to get out because they're like, why have you come here? What are you trying to do?
Boy, that is just the worst turn that you could possibly make.
Yeah, it really, it's like there's all these like guard posts and men with assault rifles and it's don't go to that.
Yeah, that's the reason why I was late for class. Is you know I got stuck in this whole web of CIA
security. See what's going on with her.
So if you went back to Langley High right now, Ross Butler would have been for like, how do you like me now with some of your classmates?
No. I was kind of I was a weird kid, and I don't say that in a negative tone. I say that more of just like I was always hopping around these different social groups and. I wasn't really, I watched a lot of movies and speaking of, I heard his favorite movie is You Got Mail.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah. I
was
watching.
How would you have heard this?
Well, the word's gotten out, Chris. The word's gotten out.
I enjoy You Got Mail. Not my favorite movie.
Meg Ryan, total babe.
Fantastic.
Tom Hanks, America's homeboy.
Yes.
You know, I would say like my guilty pleasure growing up when I was in high school. You know, have you seen 50 First Dates with...
Adam Sandler
and Drew Barrymore.
Sure, that's it.
Now I saw that maybe six times in theaters when that came out, and I don't know why. Maybe it was the Beach Boys soundtrack,
or maybe you just like anything with a number in the title.
Could be always that. Just, you're always bringing it back to the
dude. Isn't that? I mean, look, I think like you like to hang out here, maybe, but I mean, I know you're here to. I'm helping you.
Everything
promote
with the number
show.
In the title, so all the everything with the sequel, John Wick 2, John Wick 3.
Well, no, I think you like the numbers first.
Numbers
what
first.
So what's 50 First Dates, 101 Dalmatians. Did you like that movie as a kid?
27 Dresses.
You just I think you and I are on the same wavelength. Right
I'm with
now.
You, Ross.
Rom-coms.
I'm with you, buddy.
Could be that.
27.
Just throwing that all out there. Just throwing it out there.
No. Well, I mean, I was just saying that because I was watching the interview before this with Whitney Cummings. Because I mean, to be honest, coming in, because I know you're a big sports guy. I don't watch a ton of sports.
It's all good.
And I saw that Whitney literally came in with. Just a
robot.
Sex doll.
Yes, she did.
A sex robot. Well, so I'm I'm fine. If she's coming in with that, and you're talking about You've Got Mail, I'm fine. We can.
I mean, and here I thought a former chemical engineer would bring his own robot, but I mean, you just came by yourself.
Well,
that's okay.
I don't even want to get into that. I'm on a teen show. I can't talk about sex.
It's all good. It's all good.
I got to keep it under.
No, listen.
But talking about like You Got Mail, that's such like an antiquated thing that. I feel like kids now don't get why that was the name of a movie.
Dial-up internet.
You've got mail. So yeah, when you used to dial in to your computer to get your electronic mail,
right?
Yeah.
There was something called America Online that when you did connect via phone, it would say you've got mail.
You've got mail.
Right?
And there were these things called bookstores.
That's right.
Is that where they met in the movie? They met in a bookstore?
Yeah, because like Meg Ryan's character owned this really small like boutique, family-owned bookstore.
Which, by the way, was really, in the real world, eventually a cheese shop on the Upper West Side of Manhattan.
A cheese shop?
A cheese shop.
How about that?
That's right.
So whose favorite movie is You Got Mail? It looks like
that
you
guy.
Got... Well, no, it seems like you got the trivia.
No, no. Ross Butler, I'm just an expert on everything.
Oh,
I'm just
okay.
talking about him.
Okay.
And he does not like, that's where you got it from, because Whitney Cummings brought it up.
She
because
brought it up.
Go ahead, explain why you like the film. Go ahead. It's okay.
Yeah, guilty pleasure, I think, is the right phrase for it. But, like, you know, one weekend when I was a freshman in college, my mom came to visit me, surprised me. We went to saw that movie in the theater. So I'm very close to my mother, and so that you know, kind of makes me think of her.
There you go.
All right, that's nice. Yeah. I didn't go. I didn't see.
Although, did you hear
50 First Dates with my mom?
Did you hear what Ross just did? He just went the when we on the show, we think when you go higher register, you don't really believe it. He just went, all right. Like, did you
hear
that?
No, I believe it. I believe that.
No, you just did it again right there.
great actor. Great actor.
Great actor.
Great actor. Great actor. Dave Chappelle is in that movie. That's all I need to say.
It's a great film. It really is in its own right. In its own right. Not even from Mama's Boy Theater. It's in its own right.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.